Hey everyone, this is Josh with HostGator. Today I'm going to show you how to resolve some issues when you're unable to install WordPress through cPanel. Let's get started. So here we are in our customer portal. I'm going to scroll down to the hosting plan that I want to log into, and I'm going to click Launch cPanel. Now sometimes when you're using Softaculous Web Installer, it's going to give you an error message that says there's something already installed in the directory. So I'm going to show you how to resolve that today. You can scroll down to the software section here or use the quick search function to get to Softaculous. Now let's try and install WordPress on one of my domains. We'll go here and scroll over to WordPress, and we'll scroll down to install. Aha, we got our error. So it's telling me that an installation already exists on that domain, and so it's asking us to reinstall the application by uninstalling the first application that we have. So I'll show you how to do this. Let's go to the left-hand corner and click the Softaculous logo. And we'll go over here to the Installations tab. As we can see, we've got two installations already on this plan. Let's click here. Now I've got two WordPress installs already, one on b-redpit, and I've already got one on htestingaccount.com. So it's not going to allow me to install WordPress over the top of an existing WordPress installation. So now we're going to take the steps needed to remove it. As you can see, it was installed a little earlier today at 5:24. And over here, there's an option to remove it. Now, before I delete any content, we always want to make sure that we know what we're removing. And if we want to take a backup, we want to give ourselves that option too. So let's take a look and see what's on this domain. Okay, cool. So this is my first install of WordPress today to test it out. It doesn't look like I've actually built up any content on it, so I'm okay with deleting it. So let's click exit out of here, get back into Softaculous. And over here on the right-hand side, you'll see a red X. This is going to allow us to remove the installation that's already there. So we'll click that. It's going to bring us to a dialog prompt, and it's going to ask us if we want to remove the directory, the database, and the database user, all of which are created whenever we installed WordPress. If we're fine removing all that content, let's scroll down here to the bottom and click Remove Installation. Now, it's going to prompt us once more, telling us that it's irreversible and this content's going to be gone forever. So if you're okay with that, click OK. Now, I'll show you how to do a full backup of your cPanel and your site in a different video. But for now, if you had already installed WordPress earlier and you just want to simply try again, this is a great way to do it. So now our installation was removed successfully. And let's go back, take a look at our installs. And great, now we've only got one. So we can go back through the process of installing WordPress on that domain and it should work without any issue. Let's try it out. Click install once more. Choose the correct domain. Make that super secure password. And let's try and install. We've got another video on our YouTube that'll actually show you in a bit more detail how to go through the process of installing and logging into WordPress. But for now, I wanted to help y'all resolve this issue of not being able to install it if you're trying to. And there we go. No more error. And we've got a brand new WordPress installed on my domain. Let's go take a look. Awesome. So that's it. Thanks y'all for watching. If you have any comments or suggestions, feel free to leave them below. And please subscribe if you want to see more helpful videos. Have a great day.